this evening's broadcast. God richly bless you. Thank you for joining us. Today is the last Wednesday for the month of November. It's been a long journey from January to this time. We are grateful to God. And we also want to thank you for always joining us. And we study in God's word together. We appreciate it so much. God bless you. We want to share a word of prayer as we continue our study. Spirit of God, you are here as a teacher. Come and teach us. Come and teach us. Come and instruct us. In Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we started some journey. We were looking at some of Jesus' teaching concerning his coming. But we're picking those ones that relate to what we personally can do as we await, anticipate, and prepare for his coming. Indeed, if I'm to know Jesus is coming, know all the dates, know all the predictions in terms of the time, what is most important is how and in what state he comes to meet me. And that is why we are looking at these themes. So beyond I knowing he's coming, there's a season, there's the last days, there's a lot. In what state am I in? And that is what we want to look at. Today we are looking at a church in Revelation chapter 3. We may look at two. If there's not time, we'll look at one. Maybe next week we'll do the second one. In Revelation chapter 3 from verse 1, I'm reading up to verse 5, or maybe up to verse 6. In the book of Revelation, Jesus came back to his church. You know, there are so many doctrines around. But if you really want to understand Jesus, understand him with regards to what he taught before he died. And correlate what he taught before he died to what he taught after his resurrection. 40 days when he spent with the disciples teaching them about the kingdom. And when he also came back to his church through John the Revelator, visiting all the church, seven churches, and writing to them what his opinion, what his impressions are. They define Jesus' expectation. In fact, when Jesus comes to meet us as a church, he's not coming with all the criterion we pastors have given. No, forget about it. Or what some leaders have written down. Forget it. He comes with his own marking scheme, criteria, which we need to meet. So he gave us a preview. When you look at the book of Revelations, the first three chapters, and we want to pick some lessons, apply it to our lives as we await his coming. When you read Revelation, there's an expression, Maranatha, Lord, come soon. Indeed, he's coming soon, but in what state does he find us? So, Jesus came walking among his churches. He gave them commendation. Some, he gave them correction. And we want to look at these churches and apply to our lives. So, in Sardis, he says that unto the angel of the church in Sardis, these things saith he that has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know your works. You have a name that you live, but you are dead. Be watchful and strengthen the things that remain, that are even ready to die. For I have not found your works perfect before God. Remember therefore how you have received and heard, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee like a thief in the night, and you will not know what hour I will come upon you. But you have few names in Sardis which have not defiled their garments. They shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. He that overcomes, same shall be clothed in white, And I will not blot out his name out of the book of life, but I'll confess his name before my Father and before his angels. He that had an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. Amen. So this is Jesus' commentary concerning the church in Sardis. The first thing that strikes you is that Jesus is introduced to this church as the one with seven spirits. And if you look at the expression seven spirits, it was the same expression that was used in chapter 4. Revelation chapter 4, verse 5. It talked about the seven spirits. And when you come to chapter 5, verse 6, it talked the same thing, that he has seven eyes, seven horns, and also the seven spirits. So anytime you see the seven spirits, it represents the presence of God in his church with unlimited vision. Nothing escapes him. Nothing escapes him. There's something that has happened to us as a church, and God should show us mercy. If my pastor cannot see me, it means God hasn't seen me. If my friends cannot see me, God hasn't seen me. If men cannot see me, God. But you see, Jesus was introducing himself as someone whose spirit, as a seven spirit, has seven eyes, meaning nothing escapes his attention. Nothing escapes him. When you understand Jesus as such, then you know that anything you do, he sees it. Your thoughts, your motives, your intentions, when you close the door, when you put off the light, when you switch off the phone, anything, there's nothing hidden. Every dimension he can see, visible, invisible, hidden, unhidden, concealed. That is how he introduced himself to this church. Then he went on to say that I'm also the one who carries the seven stars. And when you read the translation in Revelation 1, the seven stars symbolizes the seven pastors, the seven leaders. And Jesus said, I hold them in my hands. Then he says, I know your works. So what it means is that because his eyes can see and his hands can hold us, he knows us. You are watching me this evening. You think God doesn't see. He sees it. Every labor for his kingdom, he sees it. Every sacrifice for his kingdom, he sees it. Everything you have given, time, money, effort, energy, skill, it hasn't escaped God's attention. He sees it. And that is why he told them that I know. I came to assure somebody this evening that God says, I know, my son, I know, my daughter, I know. Men may not have seen it. People even may not know. But he, the Lord, who sees us in secret, he says, I know. But the last bit is where our discussion starts. He says that you have a name. When you read it in another translation, it says you have a reputation that you live, but you are dead. This is a very sobering statement. You have a name among men, a name among your peers, a name among your superiors, a name among your community, a name among people who know you. They see you as alive. They describe you as alive. They define you as alive. But I who sees you with the seven eyes, I who sees you as a seven spirit, when I evaluate you, you are dead. Now, what is the name? The name is my reputation, how people see me, how people perceive me. But Jesus is saying that, look, Sardis, Samuel, mention your name. You may have a name, pastor of ECM, whatever titles, I can just list them, Reverend, Doctor, Professor, Emeritus, all the other accolades. And among the people I serve, I have a name. In my family, my wife, my children, I have a name. The community I live in, I have a name. But Jesus said that beneath the name, I see you as dead. What it means is that it's not so important how people see us, but it's so important to know how God sees us. Amen. Now, if you had listened to Jesus saying, you have a name, that you are alive, and you did not hear him add the last statement that you are dead, would have been lost. So what it means is that when you come close to Jesus, his tool, his lens, his scale, whatever he is using to evaluate, may be entirely different from what men use. No wonder he said it so clearly in Luke 16. He says that you are them that receive the praise of men, but what is highly esteemed among men is an abomination in the sight of God. He was talking to the Pharisees. He says that you are those who love money, and you also love the praise of men. But what is highly esteemed, that is a name, among men, in God's sight, may be an abomination. So Jesus told them the truth. You are dead. But the question people have asked is that, were they not born again? Because when you read Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1, the Bible says that we were quickened out of death when Jesus gave us life. So was it like they were not born again? And when he described them as dead, were they spiritually dead, meaning they had been separated from the Lord? Because when you talk about Jesus, he said, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. If you want to understand the concept of death, there are so many themes, but one theme relates to this, and that's what I want us to go and read. John 15, the Gospel of John, St. John. John 15. In the book of John, Jesus described himself as the vine, and he said, we are the branches. But there was a statement he made that relates to what we are looking at. Verse 5 up to verse 7. John 15, verse 5 up to verse 7. Jesus said that I am the vine, and you are the branches. He that abides in me, and I also in him, the same brings forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch. He withers, and men gather them, and they cast them into fire. Verse 7, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Amen. So if you watch Jesus' picture here, he's painting a picture that when we abide in him and he abides in us, then we receive his life and we are not dead. That is the concept that Jesus brought us. And inside that same chapter, John 10 verse 10, I'm quoting, he says that I've come that you may have life and have it. So when we are connected to the vine, we draw the vine life, Jesus' life, and we are alive and we are fruitful. But when we cut ourselves from him, we get dry and we are described as dead. So we are back to Revelation 3. What is Jesus' prescription for this problem he had seen? He said, be watchful. Now the word watchful there is so instructive, because you see, when somebody is watchful, it means he's alert. The Nigerian friends will say, shine your eyes. His eyes are bright. So Jesus' word is that be watchful. You know, there are times when Jesus told the disciples, watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. Then when he came, he found them sleeping. He said that you could not watch with me for an hour. Then that is why he explained, the spirit is willing but the flesh is weak. So the first prescription Jesus gives us is to be watchful. Watchful means that be alert, be sensitive, be responsive, look at things from my perspective. Amen. Then he told them to strengthen the things that are remaining, for they are ready to die. And I have not found your works perfect. So God was telling them that, you know, you are dead, but things around you haven't yet died with you. So strengthen them. This evening, the Spirit of God is telling us that, my son, your relationship with me is getting dead. Strengthen it. Amen. Be watchful. Strengthen it. It is not as intense. It is not as it used to. Bring some life back. So be watchful, strengthen, for they are ready to die. But the last thing he said was that, I have not found your works perfect. I have not found your works perfect. You know, when we are dead, when we are disconnected, when we are not having his life flow, what we produce, he described it as dead. Father, be merciful to us and restore us back. Then verse 3, he says, I remember therefore how you have received and heard and hold fast and repent. If you will not watch, I will come like a thief, and you will not know what hour I will come. So when we are talking about the coming of the Lord, Jesus said it many times in Matthew that I'll come like a thief in the night. He said it also in Thessalonians, I'll come like a thief in the night. But he says that what will keep us not sleeping and being caught unawares is when we repent by reconnecting and we receive back his life. Or often, yeah, me kind in a say, oh, so tea, you should church, yeah, tea in your kind answer, oh, but tea in your kind, yeah, and bro, sorry, yeah, it's answer, who sorry, yeah, no, and that they are nine, not on them, or try, he need one, some, son of Bible, catcher. But Obesia John, your throw a decent, no, Osra, then sorry. Na nin sorry ni nyina no oyin wa di kire asori no e kan ne na atochima e kan ne se osiesi e du be so hu ne a Yesu hu se so na ne a o kan ne o kan fa asafo no wa e ma wo ntiasie e ma wo hu e den ne so Yesu ani den ne so ne ni e den na Yesu hwehwe den no hwehwe e du ra Yesu ba na safo mu no ba asafo bi ne e frɛ ne Sardis. And with these Etimians, in Jichemubayako, Ekosi, in Sia. Now, yes, you know what they say. Mena, our woman soon, and your Sramon soon, Ekitaminsa. Now, in Trasi, and they say, Yakasa, yes, our woman and so on, ya kaye, Nenin soa. Ade bia en hinta no. O de be hinta nipa. O de be hinta adamfo. O de be hinta osofo. O de be hinta asoremba. Ba ne niso en hinta no da. E ti amra Yesu ba asafo we mu no se. Ne ekoso nyina mani hu. Zanza mani ne yenso. Ne etoso mienu. And stroma and soon jina homa asafum penin for an edi can for. But your candidate so no enya hear me. Djemuba or say minimunuma. That is a yes or nam ye munin now nam yujuma be a woman me on you bring you raho. I also Yami yenina obi a hu, Yami yenina sofu hu, Yami yenina sorry penny hu. I any panel we have been a missing minim. But in so cry and you bring amen. The nipe who ye na na mese mi mihu minim mihu minim mihu minim. Amen. Na ni oda kan ho ne se o se minim onjuma. Bebrebe hu nyame bat. Wanya hwe ma nyame. O ye behwe ade wa sore dem. Spectator obe make. So for the prof to say and also for the guri guri. Behwe ade fo onya prize. Wona wo bobo ni bi onya prize. Do Benjamin Fia for a dadje for a more day for Unyansa, a ye bibi. I miss you. Amen. But your candidate to us on the source, a more dean semotias in Zumo. More dean. Brother Cassam has a reputation. Udi and Yenipo, and Missu. Neokunu, Uyuru, Nanfu, and Yenipo. It is Sardis. bro no amu as of we will be a humu se washi mutiase wapo mudin babi yusu mi di meni hwe mu a mi hu ne sa mi hu sa mamu ijina jese ni yesu hu fa ye hunu ene se hia ye amen oka luka ti dun sia yesu ka sin bi o se moni woni a enipa nyina ebo jemusu na nia esu bu woni pe ni su no minya mi enim no entisa ijina jese ni nya mi hu ene ni enipa hu no enta nye pe any penisun sadis as a funny jina on asso, any penisun sadis as a funny idea, any penisun sadis as a funny or boshi. Then so yes, who send me ram on a mow, 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 mow. Let us say, yes, to who fire Huno, and I say, here ye. I also for Tando, Esio, can you mea some honor as a funny so, and he any penisun ya woo. And then I yes, so who family, and you name here ye. And I'm now here, me business. Hey, be crabby coping now. Send a yes, woman. Send an adjunct family, what's here? Man, in here. And the other toss of Mumma in the hall. Montanitin in the Akano, Nanuso. Mahumunjuma and Sonia Mieni. Mahumunjuma and Sonia Mieni. That is a new baby or her. Namieni son and so. But then you make Kenya and Zamiba. Sanya Manu, Kenya and Ibium. Amen. Now your candidate to one is all say. Say, Mansa Samadri. Now when you under war, Mepa to Sacrum for Najo. Now me ba, moon, who prayer. Me ba. Who say yes, who can say me ba to Sacrum for Canwa Matthew? And Thessalonians and Peter, Paul can in our wassam. The internet years who can say, Crom for Paul Bampo Frim, Obamra Wadina, Obamra won't shake my. And the years who say, Sir Yanian Naho, Nayan Nani Adunia, Yusu Bepano, then you really fear him. Now, where is a Crom for Abana? Papa says our name is no wonder. Now me man in Paris. Now me say a word Kenya imbue. Amen. Then what Jesus said, and I'm almost rounding up. He told them again. In verse 4, you have a few names in Sardis. They have not defiled their garments. They have not defiled their garments. Few names. Few names, few names. They shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. Verse 5. He that overcomes, the same shall be clothed in white raiment. And I will not blot out their names out of the book of life. I've touched on something very controversial, but I'll land. You know, there's a teaching that once saved, forever saved. Anything you do, you make it to heaven. But Jesus is saying, I'm going to take your name out. I'm going to blot. So don't listen to all the preachers. Listen to what Jesus said. I will blot. I will erase. I will cancel. I will remove. I remove. I believe Jesus more than any other person. He was speaking to his church. And he told them that, look, if you don't keep your garments white, I will put you out. I will take your name out from the book of life. What were they to do? He told them that, look, don't defile your garments. Don't make your garments dirty. Keep it white. What is a garment? The garment is the righteousness of God, which Jesus gave it to us as a gift. But when we don't maintain that, and we live in unconfessed sins, unrepentant sins, secret sins, hidden sins, the garment gets dirty. And like I told you, calculate all rapture dates, but you miss. Father, be merciful to us. Amen.
Amen.
Be merciful. merciful to us. Anything that has defiled our garments, anything that has spotted our garments, that will cause you to blot our names, please, Lord, be merciful to us. Be merciful to us. Be merciful to us. He says that there are few names. They haven't defiled their garments. They will walk with me in white. In white. And they that will overcome, meaning those who will copy the few by repenting, they will also be clothed in white. And I will not blot their name out of the book of life. So what it means is that as we keep our garments defiled, we are giving him the opportunity to take our names. I can be a pastor, I'm living immoral lives, I'm stealing, I'm lying, I'm a criminal, and I think the Bible is a front. My name will not be in the book of life. People can clap, people can hail, people can give me accolades and rewards. I'll miss heaven. That is the truth. And you can be watching me in the sight of men, all the reputation, but the garments are defiled. And Jesus is saying that if you don't repent, your name, I will take it out. I know it's very difficult for we preachers to preach such things, because in your mind, then who will make it? What it means is that every day you are asking for mercy and you are trusting the power of the Holy Spirit so that you can live for the Lord. I want us to read this cross reference, then I'll be rounding up. When you read the same book of Revelations, Revelations chapter 7, verse 9 and 13. Revelations chapter 7, he says that after this, I beheld, and a great multitude, which no man could number, from all the nations, kindreds, people, tongues, they stood before the throne, and they stood before the Lamb, and their robes were white. Their robes were white. But these were multitudes. Now when you come to verse 13, it says that, and one of the elders answered and said, who are these which are arrayed in white robes? And where do they come from? Verse 14. And I said unto him, sir, thou knowest. And he said unto me, these are those who came out of great tribulation, and they have washed their robes, and they have made them white in the blood of a lamb. In the blood of a lamb. Amen. So Jesus described those who will make it as those whose garments have been washed by the blood. But they are also the people who went through tribulation. What it means is the Bible says that through many tribulations will enter the kingdom. It is not going to be easy ahead of us. There's going to be persecution. There's going to be difficulties. There's going to be hardships. But let's keep the blood washing us. Washing us. When you read it in 1 John, he says that daily his blood washes us. Amen. So don't go and hide. Don't go and do. You know, there's a teaching that says everything is under the blood. Whatever sin you commit, it doesn't matter. They will take your name out of the book of life. They will take it. That's the truth. But as we come to God in repentance, we come to God in forgiveness, he shows us mercy. His blood washes us. Amen. And when you conclude, Jesus told them the last, and he says that, I will confess your name before my Father, and I will confess your name before his angels. What are we to do? Keep our garments clean. How do we keep it clean? Wash with the blood. Which blood? The blood of a lamb. Who is the lamb? The lamb that was slain, Jesus the Christ. So we are not looking at the blood of animals. We are not looking at the blood of any person. We are looking at only the blood of Jesus that can wash, that can cleanse. I don't know what tribulation you are going through. I don't know what temptations have tripped you. There is a blood that washes. When you read it in Isaiah chapter 1 verse 18, he says that, come, let us reason together. If your sins as red, they shall be white as snow. So we don't come to him with perfect garments. it may be soiled now, but the blood can wash. As you are watching me, this, there's hope. But don't hide. Don't cover. Expose it to the blood. So that when he comes, maybe just after this evening's broadcast, or when he comes, maybe tomorrow morning, our names will not be blotted out of the book of life. Lord, our prayer this evening is that as your coming comes near, anything that is soiling our garments, let your blood wash us.
Amen.
Let your blood cleanse us.
Amen.
And show us mercy.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
But often I make him and say, and church be a band, and I'm from Manu, Bonibia, we and Famu Bonibia, but you used to tear you. I had tear you. Was often not some embrace you, dear. So, or your smartphone, your smart knees. You used to say, someone's a summer journey. Na monta de fitana, and why you finu. Mamma, me moja and papa. Mudia won't come with me. May you feel you soon a kind international said, Name me a while, yeah. You didn't walk and woman, you so papa. Sasa, we end in South of your bachelor, but you soon a kind. Painting a bassa, a bride be wound, or there a mirror for from a mirror fita, and a turn in your mind. The end you pay and kikaibem. But the moja no, I will hurl. And to the moja no, who the anki can be at the bad ho. Wow, or since all bad is ah. Nia, matron, mem pepper. Me ba, who be to mini me a boom. I could be a missus. And to my same name, you may say, I'm comforted, yes, but the entire day no, and can be in the womb. Then a whole room can do. Yesu moja. And then Yesu moja. A pepanki can be a. Na ye man who cry. Oh, Yesu dim. Amen.
Amen.
I want to give a summary to all that I've said concerning this church of Sardis. Jesus gave them a chance. Says that you are dead, but you didn't know. Your garments are defiled, you didn't know. But my blood can wash. As you are watching me this evening, I don't know what has happened from January to November. But things aren't well. But the good news is that the blood is ready to wash. The blood is ready to cleanse. I am not teaching that you won't make it to heaven, you won't make it, but what I'm teaching is that if there's anything that has soiled our garment, the blood is ready to cleanse so that we can make it. But of course, my making now, they say, you used to be strong and suffer, your friend is saddest. That's what I'm saying, I'm going to say, 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 I will use with him. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to share a word of prayer. Pray it as your own prayer. Jesus, be merciful to me. You are coming soon.
Jesus.
Anything in my garment that defiles, let your blood wash. Let your blood cleanse. So that I don't miss heaven. And I don't miss the place you have prepared. Be merciful.
Help us.
Be gracious.
Help us, O
in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Father, in our own strength, we fail many times. Therefore, empower us by your Spirit. This we ask. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you for this wonderful time. Have a wonderful new month as we enter the month of December. But our names will not be blotted out. The blood will cleanse us. God bless you. Let's make our faith confession.
Because I am born of God,
I overcome Satan.
Because I am born of God,
I overcome sin.
Because I am born of God,
I overcome the world.
Why?
Because greater is he
that is in me
than he
that is in the world.
Amen.
King Jesus,
he's our life.
God bless you, Maranatha.
Jesus is coming soon.
We'll meet him. We'll go with him. Bye-bye. Have a wonderful new month. God bless you.